Wirt Electronic is a manufacturer of electronic components, for example, for technology companies, and therefore plays a huge role in getting products better and more sustainable. And that's why we're here today with Alexander Gerfer, CTO of Wirt Electronic.
Yeah, thanks for the invitation.
Yeah, thank you very much for joining us here at the Green Tech Festival. So, Alexander, why are you here at the Green Tech Festival?
Yeah, good. The Green Tech Festival is a very good platform to show the latest developments of sustainable electronics and electronic products for this. And as we are a supporter of many of startups working in this field of green and environmental friendly electronics, we want to show what we already have in our portfolio or what we can do for such kind of companies or startups or whatever the design role is coming from. Yeah.
So you see yourself as well as an enabler, right?
Absolutely, because you have great ideas, but you have to bring this idea to life, to the market. And what I learned also from my experience is I had also a startup at several times and that failed because of a single piece of an electronic component not available finally. Mm. And that is the one of the problems you have as a startup. Do I get the right piece at the right timing, especially in these crazy times where we are right now? Mm. When I want to get it for the market ready, we see it later on some of the examples. Am I ready for the market? We say, is it ready for mass production? And this is what we have as experience. We want to bring into this and give the support to these young companies to say, don't worry, you can count on us, so to say.
That's very much needed in early phase startups.
Absolutely.
As well. Yeah. So what are the products you are presenting at the Green Tech Festival?
Okay, when we are standing here right now, then is one of the key components, which we can also see, the so-called LED for horticulture or vertical farming. Mm-hmm. And the interesting thing is here, what we want to focus on is to say, we produce the food locally, where we need it, as we need it, when we need it. And we can do this in closed circuits with also closed environments, in old factory halls like here or wherever it is. And we don't need to transport the food from A to B. So the food mileage is one of the aspects here, which goes down rapidly by this vertical farming, horticulture farming. Energy saving, because LED is super energy saving. And we can trim the LED lights especially to the plant need for growing or for vitamin content or whatever.
Can this be used worldwide?
Absolutely. We have it in Dubai, we have it in US, we have it in Chile, we have it in Germany, in whatever you find. And that's very interesting. And you can grow wherever you are with a closed environment, this plant here in any country, any location. Yeah, absolutely.
So that's a real game changer when we talk about food, right?
Correct. And what you learn and what you have to learn is which crop needs which light, mm-hmm. which intensity, which wavelengths, and so on, and how does this go for the best growing vitamin content and so on. So we give here full support because we have our own development team and R&D team, and we work together with the TU Munich, Tom, so to give here recipes, so to say, for the users, and we have special development kits, so it's ready to play with, let's say it this way, ready to develop on with. And if it comes in for mass production or the first prototyping, we are here even to support how to get this into the field.
Okay.
That's the role we see here.
Yeah. That's great. And you have a second product, right?
Yes, absolutely. It's again about the green aspect.
Yeah.
It's from another company we supported. It's Agranimo. That's the keyword is here a bit like Internet of Tomato or Internet of Salad or Internet of Growings. You have to water it, but you water where you need it.
Yeah.
Or you give some kind of support for growth where you need it and not plain over the whole field, over the whole area. So what we do here, or what they do here, they measure the content of the growing contents, the feeding contents, and then you decide in the cloud, you see how your area is growing and how the contents are, and then you can decide what to do. Yeah, so that's again saving of things and not letting things go here.
Energy, as you said.
Energy is one aspect, but chemicals or supporting chemicals for growing or even watering, whatever it is around. Yeah.
Okay. And what is your contribution as Wirt Electronic for a more sustainable world?
Let me give you a quick example on this one. It's again the small detail which was a problem here is about how to get the data into the cloud and how mm-hmm. to in different environment countries and regions, how to get this, so to say, under the regulations of RF communications.
Yeah.
And for the what do we do is in our own application for the market, we say we want to do the maximum of output, so to say. So if we get raw materials into the production lines, if we put the energy into production lines to put our own production lines on highest efficiency, less crap or less waste.
Yeah.
And of course, all what we do is on the way to say saving then things. So produce locally wherever we can also with our components. So reduce mileage again, go closer to your applications. So one thing coming up for the next years is, especially for our field, 3D printing. That is the next step to say, I can produce more locally and save things again.
Yeah. How important is circularity for you as a company? Sorry? Circularity?
This is what is coming more and more. Also it starts, first of all, we want to have designs which work long time in the field, also lasting 10 years and more, and not only 3 years or 1 year. And when we can get the pieces back for putting gold out, nickel out, then of course that's one of the key aspects which gets more and more important for the market. It starts already with some kind of plastics, yeah. And the technology is now going that it's really efficient to do it. And we can do it with machines now, nice machines there on the market. Mm-hmm. And that's coming up more and more because the raw materials, again, are limited sources.
Yeah.
They're not unlimited in the planet.
Yeah. Okay. I heard about your Unleash Future boat. What is it about?
Okay, it's a support of us for this invention, a very nice invention, and it makes mobility available over the river, so to say, from one border to the other, and sustainable, not using old technology again. And in places where it's really difficult to go, so not enough water depth and whatever. So they worked really hard here to make this working. We showed it already outside. And we have such an example right now. I'm from Cologne, and they've closed the bridge, and people were very angry right now, I have to say. And they say, we have to go a mile, now extra mile, to reach this small island. And such kind of boat would be the perfect example to use there, because it's autonomous drive, so to say. You bring the people from one border to the other border, and they decided to go, of course, they don't know the Unleash Future boat, they have to talk eventually to the Cologne people, but they decided other ways, which are way more expensive and take more time to get that approved. So this is really a kind of thing where we have many cities, where we have collapsing bridges, so to say, and people want to go from A to B. They want to cross the river, and thus such kind of autonomous movement in such a kind of boat for the bicycle, the pedestrians, is one of very interesting piece of a puzzle of mobility where we could help them to go again with our support a bit faster for the market. That already hard work, but we can see it outside and see it outside how it's looked like, and it's a very interesting thing where we are happy to support.
So one part of the Green Tech Festival are obviously the startups. What are you going to do in the following days? What do you expect? What do you want to see?
Yeah, of course, we hope that many startups and companies come around to see our booth here and talk to my team and to my colleagues here. And as Würth Electronic, we are looking and working for companies to say we are, in first aspect, your best partner. So if you have any kind of technical problem, and you need your high-speed market solution, so you want to go fast-speed to the market, you cannot know everything right away from scratch. You have to have some partners supporting you, bringing your design to work. And we love hardware, as we can see, even you can see the hardware here physically, also in color.
Yeah.
So, but am I the expert for everything? And in our range of offerings of components, there are many small details which could lead to a delay. And we say, don't worry, talk to us. Even if you're a very small company, don't hesitate to ask. We are here for you. And we make your idea with our expertise, our network, growing. And that is one of the key aspects for us. Because, as I said before, I had already a time where I had a startup not working, not because of the idea, not because of the market, because of a missing single piece of that solution. And we don't want to have this in the startups we want to support, and we love this support, so that's our offering. Also, don't hesitate to ask, and we help you to speed up your time to market.
So Wirt Electronic is helping you with your ideas. Maybe you can contact the team.
Absolutely.
Or Alexander. They will be happy if you contact them. And yeah, thanks a lot for joining us today at the Green Tech Festival, and have a nice one.
Thank you.